Patterson. This is Daniel Tran. Today we're going to look at six simple submissions that every beginner jiu-jitsu needs to know. We're also going to throw in some kind of more advanced ideas on them as well to show you how to put some combinations together, try for one thing, get a little bit of energy, and then move on to something else. So the first one we're going to look at is from the guard. We're going to look at two submissions from the guard, learn how to put them together a little bit. So basic first one is we call a six count armbar. So I always usually like to start with one hand in the collar because now I can threaten the choke and the armbar at the same time. So there's my first grip. My second grip is above the elbow, so he can't pull his arm back. So I've kind of got it stuck up here. I'm kind of grabbing the seam of the gi above his elbow. That's number two. Number three, I open this foot up, but not out to the side. I open it straight up like I'm shaving the side of his body, put a little bit of resistance, put that foot in the hip. Number four, around the back side of, across the lat and around his back. Number five, leg over the head. And number six, lift the hips. Again, one, two, three, four, five, six. One more time. One, two, three, four, five, six. Now, sometimes what happens is I go to grab this and he's postured up a little bit and this arm is already straight because he's trying to push me away from him. Oftentimes, I'll skip the six count and just go right into a jumping arm bar where I release the feet, hop the legs up and come here. This is another very good way to play the arm bar. Here, get those hips up and come around. Now, next one, cross choke. When you're doing the cross choke, say he's got good posture, his hips are up, it's hard for me to get this hand deep, the choke's never gonna work with my hand here. So, I come up and get that hand all the way around the back of his neck. Let's turn this way a little bit. Good. Get that hand all the way around the back of his neck. So, when it's back there, I can almost hold his head down with the back of my hand. I'm not gassing out my grip trying to pull as hard as I can to make him down there. I'm using the back of my hand for a lot of that power, and this is kind of loose, unless I really need it. If he starts to try to go away from me, then I'll grip for a second, pull him back down, but then I'll get my control again. Remember here, anytime you're going for the choke, it's important you want to use your legs. That's a big part of keeping them close to you. It's not all the power from my upper body. So now, once I have this hand in deep, that second hand, I'm going to pull forward with my legs, is going to shoot underneath. This hand is going to release. So I get a nice, tight, deep grip, and then I pull his head in and choke him out. Again, so come up, one, two, three. Now, this is where these two techniques come together really well, because sometimes what happens is I start going for the choke, and then he puts his hand over the top and starts resisting. My hand's not deep enough, I can't maybe get the choke. So from here, just bring the leg over and put it together with the armbar. So again, I'm trying for the choke, he's pushing over the top, go to the armbar. Or maybe I'm trying to set up the armbar and he starts killing that, come right back, go to the choke. Again, I start setting up the armbar, he brings it back, come in, go to the choke. So two basic submissions, you can put them together different ways depending on what energies he's giving you. Now, these same two submissions, we're gonna play from the mount, from the crossbody. And look how it's so basic, armbar and choke in each position, and linking them together from the choke to the armbar, from the armbar to the choke, will really give you a lot of opportunities and a lot of advantages when you're attacking from those positions. So go ahead and lay down, let's take a look at the mount here real quick. So from the mount position, we'll start with the basic choke. I'm gonna come inside, I get that hand nice and deep. Again, just like on the first one, I want to get it as deep as I can. However, his back and sometimes his head's on the mat, so I can't maybe get it all the way around as deep as I did before, but it's still in there nice and deep. that second hand, sometimes, depending on how he is, I might need to lift his chin up with my elbow a little bit. I release my grip just like before, get that hand in tight. Now, from here, whatever hand is on the top, so in this case, my right arm is on top, I want my head to go to this side of the mat when I come down to choke. Okay, so again, I get that first hand in nice and deep, and oftentimes, if the gi is nice and tight here, don't try to go for the choke right away. Loosen it up a little bit, and get that hand nice and tight, lift the jaw, reach inside, and choke. Number two, hands in tight. He's defending, he doesn't want me to go for the choke, so this elbow's off the mat. So I'm gonna step up with there, with my knee, and now I'm behind him. I'm gonna cross face and turn him up on his side. I've got a good tight control. This hand's on the mat for base. It's hard for him to move. Swing that leg over, come down, and you can grab the wrist bone in the crack of your elbow here and use that for leverage, and come down and pull and lift the hips. Or sometimes I'll grab like I'm shaking his hand so he can't twist his wrist out, and go here and lift the hips. Again, so he's worried about the choke, he doesn't want me to get it, he gives me a window to come up here. Cross face, come around, and back down to the arm bar. Now, just like what we did from the guard, say I'm trying for the arm bar, and he knows I want that arm bar, and he insists on bringing that elbow back down to the mat. When he comes down, he gives me that window to slide that hand in, and then I go to the choke. I'm trying for the choke, and he closes up, he gives me the window to go for the arm bar. So again, just like in the last position, we're using those two basic submissions as a combination, one leading into the other. Now, I'm gonna do the same thing one more time from crossbody. Crossbody, we'll look at the arm bar first. So we're gonna start here, and notice how if he's smart, he doesn't want to give me this arm. He's keeping it hidden in my armpit here. So from this position, one way I can work towards getting that hand out is I'm going to move my hips a little bit towards the north-south side. This elbow is going to come back. I'm going to get my elbow inside, and I'm going to use that can opener and peel it out. Now I wrap the arm around my head side, or his head side, and this hand is going to grab my lapel. Here, I pull him up on his side, and I want to be around the meat of the shoulder so I can lift. Keeping this nice and tight, use your leg for leverage. Now, even right here, I've had people tap from this. This can put some good pressure. If I hold this loose, pull your arm out. It's easy to pull the arm out. Come back. Pull your arm out. It's tight. Right now, he can't go anywhere. And then just step across, turn, and there's the arm bar. Again. So, start from here. I move a little bit north-south, just enough to get that elbow inside. I peel it out, lock it up, cinch it up. Pull him up on the side. Slide this knee in for support. Use that leg to put pressure on his arm. Step, turn. Now, gotta put it together so we look at the choke. So, to set up the choke solo from crossbody for this version of the choke that we're using, we're gonna want him to turn him aside a little bit, almost like he was trying to do an elbow escape. So, we get him down, he kind of works his way up, and by him turning on his side, it's giving me a window down here to slide this hand in nice and deep on his neck. Then this one, I'm gonna come across, get the thumb in, bring that hip down, and choke. One more time. So I'm here, he gets up on his side a little bit, gives me a window, I slide this hand in nice and deep, and notice how the whole time, this is something I see beginners do a lot. When they're here, they're trying to get this hand in, so they back up, and they come here, and they take some of that pressure off of him, which is gonna let him escape. So, when he comes up on the side, I don't wanna take any pressure. I'm using the live foot and I'm putting weight into them, come up on your side a little bit, but I'm still staying heavy on them, not giving them any space. And then come up, lock it up, and choke. All right, now what happens is sometimes I'm trying for the arm bar, I get him up on the side, and he uses this hidden force here and pulls that shoulder back down. He overpowers me and he gets ahead of me. So I'm gonna do it again. Please just start from here. I get up. When I feel him start to overpower me, this hand takes advantage of that gap and comes in right away. And then I snake it up, and now I've got my choke again. Maybe he's on his side, and I start going for the choke, and he doesn't want me to get the choke, so he's really defending this hand here. It's giving me trouble. I can take my head down, come back, and go right into the armbar. So he gets up on his side. I start trying to get that choke. Okay, feel the arm. Come out. And here. So, two simple submissions, arm bar, cross choke. And we're doing that from three different positions. That's the kind of bread and butter submissions. You want to know those and practice those, get really good at those. Those are just a couple basic variations of all of those. But as you get better, you want to see how many different ways can you do the cross choke and the arm bar? How many different ways can you get into it from those different positions and often different energies? So keep up with the training. Look forward to seeing you next time. Please, if you're enjoying the content, subscribe below. We're trying to put out at least a couple videos a week to give you guys some fresh stuff to look at. And we appreciate your time. Thank you.